Metropolitan International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro, and Barara. Contact or WhatsApp us on 0772-561-957. Email us at metropolitaniu@gmail.com. Empowerment through knowledge creation.
Empowerment to knowledge creation. There I go, of course. This is Rush Talk, and my name is Miles Ramiti Apuli. We're here up to the hour in about 30 minutes. Yes, we shall be away. Nevertheless, my friend is here with us. Of course, she's so much unknown, of course, especially, of course, in showbiz controversies here and there. A lot of young girls look up to her. She's a well-traveled, exposed lady and one of the trendsetters in Uganda. And it seems, of course, to people, especially like we said, young girls, follow her and that generation, of course, of what she has done. Today, want to help to understand the young people who actually commonly known as, of course, the Generation Z. Of course, join us when we will as welcome one Judith Hard, my friend. How are you doing, Judith?
I'm doing well, I wrote a poorly.
Yeah, good chat. Yeah,
popular though. A young at work.
Yeah, talk Charlie. Oh, that I wrote at work.
India Kurong, my valley mill.
To room for ample in similar Miss Kuanu, but the Manilok was a Kurong you told Miss
Ego Manide to gain that to Obtuja Kampala into a Sibar Uganda mono. And, recently, nkarola many comments nibekaguza abwaki na abazoluganda nkatalumanyire na bakaguza nyo ndi muganda mdioke mbazoluganda kuru
mali
ego so nagambo manyire ni nasalahu ninja kubaza gortoro na bantu bengi bali surprised that I can actually
including
speak.
Me I didn't know
yeah
I didn't know which is
well
thank
you for having me here.
You're welcome. You come, we'll be back from other countries. We understand we're not been here.
Yes, I haven't been in the country.
Yes, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm super, super blessed and grateful.
Okay. Where have you been?
I've been around the world. I was recently in Milan for Milan Fashion Week.
Okay.
But I got a little bit of an issue. My luggage didn't make it with me to Milan. Ended up delivering it one day prior the end of the shows, so I didn't get to attend anything. But yeah, I'm grateful that
I could take that
trip. Yes.
How is family?
Family is beautiful. My kids are growing very, very big, girls and boys, and they look healthy, very blessed.
That's good. Are you still modeling?
Oh,
now that you are, now that you had gone to Midan, what do you get a moon? Maybe Tatabo.
Oh, money, what you mean, Mojota Sovolo Kuva, Coca, Tinga, HR modeling. At the end of the day, I still have it all. And the mama, Nayango, Movie, Guchari,
World. Eh, that's a who is Ocho Chikorosia. Only mama, Nemo, Vilogami, Neda.
Oh, so easy. Ruliku Nacho, which is very important. O money was Sigalako Nacho. You're not struggling to keep anything with shape. So,
yes.
Omovidi, we are blessed that I'm skinny and naturally skinny. I don't waste my time in the gym.
Really? You never go to the gym?
I don't go to the gym.
Or the diet, maybe.
I'm not a gym person. So,
maybe your diet. You watch a lot about your diet.
Not really. What's
your favorite food?
My favorite food is matoke.
Local food.
Matoke. Matoke, beans, ginut sauce, and luwombo and cocoa. And I do love to cook for myself lately. So, yeah, I eat a lot of chicken. I'm trying to put on a little bit of weight.
Oh, you want weight now? Okay. There you go, Narong. Now, Narong, you people in Generation X have been setting trends for Generation Z. Mm-hmm. Do you think you are doing it well, or these young people have been misled?
To be honest, in our generation had it really rough.
Yeah, true.
We really struggled through the streets, but we thank God that we managed to push through and create names we still have today. No matter where I go, and somebody will always say that's Judith Hard, and I wouldn't have done it without God. So we hustled our way through. Tukatoa muno oranganya
njia kwa zoto.
So generation yetu tukabona bona muno okurabamu okikaki ha dreams zetu. tukakuri tuwe mu generation no manyango mwana mmoja still ni wa kusingwa mwisiki. That's how we, that's our generation.
Because
then tumanya, it's the man first. Oineku, you have to praise the man. You have to do this for the man. You, to get a job, it's always been men first. For us coming up, it's always been the men first. The men first. But the generation today is very lucky that it's an open market. It's a, it is a big sea for everybody to be able to fish. But then how are you fishing?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, our generation, we didn't have even social media. Nowadays we have all kinds of platforms where you can go and read and educate yourself. But still So today it's a bit different, definitely.
So but you see, all of our recently in a video, 14, they're twerking or ali, you know, no gamba. Is this the kids to blame? The schools they go to, or even the parents?
That is a very tough one because I don't want to judge any mother, any father. But it comes back to us. How are we raising our children? What are we accepting in our homes?
Mm-hmm.
There is accepting twerking if the mother is also twerking. If you are a professional dancer, definitely you'll always be dancing in your house. So your children are going to be brought up by a dancing mother and they're going to fall in love with dancing. And what are we watching on TV? Yes, we tetucha ina bude bwa kugamba alabachi ku TV.
The kids, yes.
Balabachi. Lately tuli kumulembe gwa amasimu. Buli mwana agenda kusomero na alaba muninga ine simu. Akomawo waka akaba nange njagala simu. You're forced to get that phone ngo muzate ayagalizo mwana. And then we forget that the minute you hand over this phone, togenda kufuna budde buddayo following up ali kuchichichiche yakebede. But when you're clever, there are parents that have a magezi agokutekamu spyware.
Yes.
But also, why are we going to spy on a child like this? So it's what you accept in your home. It's what you're showing your children. I regret from what I've done in the past, because today it affects me.
But do you regret that?
Yes, I some things are not supposed to be done, but tukula tuiga.
Yes.
So I've learned from my past, and today I have amazing children. My son is turning 17, my twins are turning 14, but when I look at my children, I am very, very proud. I look at them and I'm like, okay, my daughter has the audacity to tell me, mother, knock at my door before you come into my room.
Mm-hmm.
Mom, you can't just walk into the bathroom. I'm showering. So, echo chimpa amanyo kulaba mwana wanga chainako akensonyi. So, waliwo abana abayitawo, abayisewo, and it's because of social media.
Exactly, yes.
Social media leso obuzibu mukukuza abana baffe.
Okay.
Mara muwe simu toddayo ogenda kuyiriba. You're hustling, you have this meeting, you're trying, wanochiganye, odnonya office, indala jogendamu, okoma wallet, you're disappointed, waliwe bitayisemu, orwanye netimu, your colleagues,
correct.
You come back home, omwana yasibye kusima, alimu holiday. You know, for God's sake, temunimba, baba, mama, batata. Ogenda kudda waka after all that stress. But lucky, some of us, I have my mother, my sister Jackie. I thank my sisters and my mother for actually keeping a very close eye on my children. I do try myself, but I cannot be perfect. Nangen Charlie, muku recovering, I've made some mistakes in the past that I'm trying to fix. But I fixed it by apologizing and accepting God in my life. So yes, chitandikira ku chiche chiri mu makaga fe na yetu ino kugeza ako neturwanyisa abana baffe bali mukukula every day. Omwana w'obuwala avayo nakola ekintu and you're heartbroken. When I watched, I actually watched a short clip of Nicole dancing.
Mm-hmm.
But when my friend was translating the story of how she was beaten, it broke my heart.
Oh no.
I was crying. I'm like, Banange, we've gotten abana abatoba to sekulevu. Eyokwe planning ira. Nemukwata nemukuba munamwe. Things that we never done in the past.
Okay.
But today the sea is so big, but how do we fish? It takes us back to how do we manage everything that is around our children? Boba be managing zebatia. So if you're clever enough, they should start listening. For us, we've lived today. Thank God that I can sit and share my life with the people like, out there.
Because the kids are watching you right now.
And they
I'm follow you.
Yeah, I'm not saying don't live like this. I'm not judging anybody. But for the past 2 years, we went through a pandemic. A pandemic yakuzabuli omu in 1 second.
Yes.
It was a split.
Yeah.
Everybody's mind is both. Your mind either grew big or your mind grew smaller.
Mm-hmm.
And some people turn to God. I turn to God.
Oh, which is good.
Because 2 years in the pandemic, and then you come back, you go to the same lifestyle. I was like, no. And I think the pandemic yali signing a katonda tulaga. Right direction. Or you stay in the pit latrine.
There you go. Of course, Judith had here sharing her story and telling us exactly the way she, you know, what she passed through and advising a few, of course, of our young people. Now, today's young people are wild and very materialistic. Very materialistic. We had a parent whose leaked audios showed he was stressed by what his daughter was doing. Another one was beaten by friends. Of course, you've been talking about that. Mm. So what do you think is causing this?
Again, social media. We have Netflix.
Netflix? Oh, yes. Yes.
We have Netflix. Mm-hmm. We have reality shows on every channel you can imagine. Every social media platform allows everybody to create their own life. So if I have a child that has an iPhone 14 plus, I don't know. You don't know how I make my money.
Exactly.
You don't know how their father makes their money, darling. And then your child is going to come back and want that i14 plus.
Okay.
Just because they saw some other child living with an iPhone 14 plus. This is social media. Omwana wona kubona abonya. I want this phone. I want this phone. But guess what, sweetheart? I don't make the same money as the mother of the child you see with an iPhone. So abana bafabo kuwala nabobulenzi lately. Lately,
yeah.
I'm here to speak the truth and what I've seen and what is going on. There is no time to sugarcoat anything. We have young boys out there just doing anything for an iPhone 14 Pro. We have young girls out there doing whatever they can for the life that Judith had is living. You're forgetting that I've lived.
Exactly.
I have a father of my children.
Exactly.
That is worked. I have worked. Before, Ramiti, Apul.
Yes.
Nyowe, by the time I pick something, ikakwata mungaro izange, ninyenda kuwa 150%. If what I'm holding in my hands disappears today, I can be able to replace it for myself.
Exactly. Exactly.
This is how I live my life.
Exactly.
If I'm going to hold a bag, I want a designer bag. And I'm going to hold it because I can afford it for myself. And that's why I don't rush for anything. I live peacefully. I live happily in my own capacity.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is why you say I'm gonna stay here forever. People have busted me. People have called me names. I've fallen back and still rose up. And that is because I know what I want in life. I know how I want to live my life. Mm-hmm. I don't want to live life that I can't afford.
Yeah. And which is a problem in this generation, that they want for the situation a life that's not theirs.
So you find a girl that is inspired by Judith Hyde, inspired by Sheila Geshumba, is going to end up getting in trouble because they want to live a life. They don't know how it's created. You don't know how it's created. Sheila spends her Monday to Monday hosting different nights. You cannot do it.
Yes.
I'm being honest with the public.
Yes.
I don't have that energy. And that is why I'm not going to dream for the life she's living, because I can't handle it.
Yes.
So I choose to live my own kind of understanding life. And that's why it keeps me out of trouble and it keeps me peaceful. So abana bobu wala abana bobu lenza bali out there. Chema ino kuhiga,
ino
kumanya. Ku social media, osala wacho ya gala kutera wo mtu.
Oh yeah.
Nze nja kutera wo, nguze simu iPhone 14 Plus. Tomanyo ba nze nda jegulide, tomanyo ba waliwe ya jingulide.
Exactly.
Ogenda kubona abona.
Mm.
Ngogeza ko jifuna. So, mukubona abona oku, waliwo ogenda kutoka. Ofunemo obuzibu.
Yes.
Ngo chesinga, che wala bie ku social media.
Mm.
So, che, what I would say to the youth, to the generation out there, you guys have potential, you guys have it all. We're here to inspire you. We're here to inspire you, but also at the same time, I'm learning from the youth. I'm learning from the generation that we have today. They are so creative, they are educated, they have it all. So I would advise you to actually leave your own limits. Don't be taken up by social media. People choose to show you what they want you to see, not what they're going through. People are going to attack you on social media, but in real life, when you look at the person, I always go like, oh, wow, that is you?
I know.
Go on, God bless you, you know? Because abantu asala wacha ya gara kutera ku social media. Jakula gayemo gaga tenga ewawe. Mama we akaba tufuna sukari.
Exactly.
Aja kutera unga popinga champagne. Ne wogenda kwete gereze nga toze za fake. Aja kula gamba living the most expensive
exactly.
life. But botula kogera na ye. Tasobola na kogera chintu chitegere keka.
Oh yeah.
So this That's is very the correct. Life you should
very,
stay
very
away
correct.
From.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, lastly, you are a parent and very exposed, of course, very exposed to kids from a cross-cultural marriage. How do you parent them? Do you, like, Chiboko, do you do that or, you know, you just talk to them?
God bless now that my they're children. Big. God bless my children. I've been very lucky to have very respectful children, God-fearing children. Their father, I was very, very blessed. Yali muntu atia katonda, muntu atia katonda.
Okay.
So tufunye chance ya wana wafo kukulira mukatonda.
Mm.
Wadenzi nalisina wakola chichi ingiramu.
Mm.
Bada wana wange wakulide mudini.
Okay.
So nange katindi musanyu fokulaba nange ngantuse kusawa. Enjoying the spiritual life. So yeah, we're not complaining. Abana wafo bali mixed, but by that part, I thank God for my mother, Baganda Bange, Bali, very traditional. Muganda Wangabera, like out of town, Abera Matuga, so she has that farm life.
Oh.
They love animals, they love every natural thing. So
okay.
It's helped me to work with the Bulunji, Tewali Mbunze, and Dimuzungu. No, Tuba Gamba, no, darling. Mama, I'm from East Africa, I'm African. You have to add African, what the Mwazali from America. But darling, you still come to our side. So we act
know.
African, we act American, we act as an international family.
Okay. Now, this I want you to talk to the, you know, especially to the young kids, you know, who actually in holidays right now. Mm-hmm. Lately, you've seen what they are doing. They want to do, like you said, actually, you mentioned about it earlier on, that, you know what, these kids want to put a situation, you know, because they have seen other, you know, children doing this. Oh, we want to be like this. Mm-hmm. They feel they are big. They are uncontrolled. So many things happen. Now, I want you to talk to them, you know, comparing your life. Of course, yeah. you said you went through a lot of hassle. Mm-hmm. What has kept you moving? What has kept you going? Even when, you know, sometimes you're low. then you raise up. So what is that thing that has kept Judith Hart moving forward, no matter what?
No matter what, to be honest, God has kept me moving forward.
Mm.
You know, I might have not paid attention, but when I look back, I can say, yeah, God has always been on me. He's not let me go. I messed up here and there, and then I recovered from it, and I still gonna act like I don't know.
Mm.
Of course, definitely, God has always been in my life. God was involved, and today, Nianza Katonda, Okubana took a point again, but and Charlie, I still look good. Katonda is involved, but how do I actually thank him? So I turned to God, and it's been the most beautiful journey that I've ever taken. I don't remember the last time I had woken up at 6 a.m. I don't remember the last time I had said, thank you, God. I don't remember the last time I had just said, oh my goodness, I've been blessed. I have this. I have family. I have friends. I still have opportunities knocking at my door. I still see doors being opened.
Mm.
You know, I'm still able to stand and speak and be heard. So chenasala wanasala to get closer to God, to know God, because honestly, after the pandemic, there is nothing out there that I'm really interested in. There is nothing out there that is gonna make me feel like, oh my goodness, I miss this. No, I've seen it all. And kumwana omwana wobuwala obomulenzi eyafuna chance eyita mu pandemic nabanga lero akyasa nabanga lero akyasobola okugenda ku ssomero nabanga lero akyasobola kufuna ekyokulya. Who are you to even feel like, oh no, I got it, oh, I was born lucky, I'm
you know
gonna
what I mean?
Do this. Like, are you crazy? After 2 years and you're back and you're able to go back to school when some of your friends are actually dropped out, you're still eating at home. What are your families have? Abatalia.
Oh yeah.
Do you understand?
Yes.
So there are families that until today have not recovered from the pandemic. You know, so
and here you are.
And here you are. You go to a nice school. You go to any school. It doesn't even matter what school it is, for God's sake. As long as you go to a classroom, you should be grateful and you should be trying as hard as you can to know who God really is, to understand who you are, to understand why you're still living, to understand your calling is very, very important. So all I can say is try. I want the young generation, for God's sake, munonye katonda, muike, musome, mumanye katonda. Oja kusome bitabo byo, o some bulunji, o vemu bulunji, o vele successful. There is nothing like finding God. Honestly speaking, I'm not gonna beat anyone's child. I'm not gonna judge anybody. I'm not gonna tell you this is wrong, but there is so much. It's all out there in our faces, but you never know what is wrong until you find God. Because I've done it all, but I didn't know what I was doing. I thought I was living the best life. But today when I look back, I'm like, oh, wow, did I just do that? Did I even think of this? So I think it's important.
Okay. Okay. Now, this is now personal kind of questions. Yeah. What's your favorite color?
I used to be a very dark angel. I used to love black, and I still believe black is very classy, but lately my life is more lively. My life is bright. I feel so bright. I feel so fresh, young, sexy, very colorful. So you're always going to find me in different colors, but I think white is right now my favorite color.
White.
Because it is my life. My life is very pure. My life is clean. It is white. It is angelic. So yes, white is going to be.
Are you a fast driver?
Yes, I'm a very, I love cars. I love sports cars. I am a very good driver. I can drive to anywhere you want in Africa. Yes.
You can drive. What is under your bed?
Under my bed. Oh my goodness, that is so funny.
Anything under your bed?
Bed?
Mm-hmm.
Under my bed is actually my most important valuables. I'm not going to mention
what. Okay.
Yeah.
Are you a short-tempered person?
Not really.
Okay, if you cut a wire, what do you do?
If I cut a wire, I just block you for a few days. Because when I cut off a wire, I feel really damaged.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a soft person. I love so hard. And I love happy people. I love to be happy. So,
Okay, and finally, your favorite designer?
Oh, my favorite designer, you mean Ugandan?
I know, no, foreign, of course, we all like. I know who you like, Ugandan, but.
Ugandan, I'm actually in love with all the designers, and thanks to all my official designers, SKP, Maribeth, A. Bryant, of course, he styles me. Somehow, and Raska Sozi, every designer in Uganda that has worked with me, I sent you a big shout out. But my favorite designer in the world, I think that would be Christian Dior. Yeah, he's my favorite designer. I love mostly his white collection. It's always classy. I love, it's classy and ages, so I love it.
Okay, so lately, what helped you to like in a business?
Lately, I have a foundation. It's Judith Hyde Foundation. We started mainly focusing on children and mothers, but then as Miss Environment Africa 2022, I started a project which is 50 million trees for Africa, and this is a project that is going to go all over Africa. We plan to plant 10 million trees in every African country, and that is a project called 50 million for Africa by 2050. So we call upon all government, private sectors, individuals, church leaders, political members that would love to join the campaign. You can always get in touch with us at Judith Hyde Foundation.
That's a website.
We have a website. Okay. It's www.judithhydefoundation.org, or you can actually reach us. I know so many people are watching and you would love to have my number. But apuli niwe mtu omwine kuhikira mkamkaguzi namba ya toki tulatunga tuta.
Exactly. There you go. Thanks so much for short notes to be with us. We'll definitely bring you back here because a lot we have to hear from you here and there. Chali wevale muno kuija. And of course, those of you watching, you can join still the conversation on our show shows. That is Urban TV Uganda. Of course, that's Twitter, Instagram, and of course, yeah, TikTok. There you go. You'll definitely be able to catch us on live. Have a great day. And of course, enjoy yourself. Great week.
God bless you.
Rush Talk, brought to you
by Metropolitan International University, a multi-campus university with campuses in Kampala, Kisoro, and Barara. Contact or WhatsApp us.